Hey everybody, it's me, Mark Wiggins, the Speaker Man, coming to you live and direct, sorta. But I wanted to get on today and talk about a topic or a chapter from my new and upcoming book, Success Does Not Need a Co-Signer. The topic for today, in the next few minutes, is kryptonite. What is your kryptonite? Now, we all know, as soon as you say the word kryptonite, we begin to immediately think about, or you should think about, Superman, right? Because that's what the word was kind of brought out, Superman. Superman was not as strong or as good as he could be when kryptonite was around. Well, kryptonite came from the planet Krypton, and it really blocks the sun, and we know that the sun is where Superman gets his energy from, so you block the sun, Superman is weak. Now, if we put that in a modern terminology or a modern lexicon, we know that kryptonite is anything or someone that comes around and makes you weak. For instance, that girl comes around, and she comes around, and all of a sudden I lose my mind, I become weak. Because she is a kryptonite, right? So you have to be able to manage the kryptonite. If you cannot manage your kryptonite, then you're going to be in trouble. Even now, when I wrote this chapter a while ago, it was before Wonder Woman is coming out, right? Wonder Woman is out, you know, Diana Prince, the Amazon Princess, whatever. Do you not know that Wonder Woman has a kryptonite, or weakness, if you will? It's piercing objects. Her lasso of truth can be used against her. And if she clicks her things together, she can actually become weak some kind of way. And don't forget, she may not be able to find the invisible jet. Don't know where it is, only she knows. But you've got to know what your kryptonite is. Now, when we say kryptonite, we often think that it's a bad thing. Kryptonite may not be a bad thing. It may be something good that you like to do, but it becomes all-consuming and takes you from your goal. It therefore makes you weak and not get your goals. So therefore, in that instance, your kryptonite would be whatever it is you like to do. For me, I love watching ESPN. I don't know why, I just do, and I watch it again and again like I've never seen the episode before. Well, if I spend a lot of time watching ESPN in the morning, I can get a little lazy. And once I get a little lazy, then I don't do what I'm supposed to do. So therefore, ESPN and the wrong situation becomes my kryptonite. As entrepreneurs, people looking for success, trying to get off the bench and get into the starting lineup of life, you've got to identify what your kryptonite is. If I put it in the world of sports, you must work and identify on your weakness, right? Not to make your weakness better. Sometimes people would say, you know, you work on your weakness to make you better. Actually, you work on your strength to cover up the weakness. So if you spend a lot of time on the weakness, then what if it doesn't get better? It's just something that that's not strong in your game. You've got to learn how to manage that weakness. Same thing with your success. You need to look at what are your distractors. What are your people or things that take you away from where you want to go? It could be that relationship, the bad one. The negative one, the one that takes up all your bandwidth and makes you feel some kind of way because you spend so much mental energy trying to analyze the craziness you just went through, that is a distraction. Now, relationships aren't kryptonite. Just certain things about the relationship you may be in may be your kryptonite. Again, you've got to identify your kryptonite. Once you identify the kryptonite, you can then manage how you get through it. And if your kryptonite is a lot of different things that you like to do, then you put that as a reward. I got a series of friends that love to work out, and I hear them all the time. I'm going to the gym. I'm at the gym. Hey, I'm in the gym. I'm in the gym. I'm in the gym. I'm in the gym. They miss 37 minutes from the gym, and oh, my God, my life is a mess. Oh, I think I picked up a half a pound. In those instances, not working out is a kryptonite, but going to work out becomes the kryptonite because it takes you sometimes away from your focus. Now, they'll argue with me and say, no, it doesn't, Mark. I love to work out. It keeps me where I need to go. Uh-huh. But when it becomes so obsessive to you, that's all you think about, I dare challenge you that sometimes you won't get your job done. Because when you happen to miss a workout, you become so obsessed that you missed that workout, like as if 8 hours is going to put 35 pounds back on you. I could be wrong. I'm just saying. Those are the things that are kryptonite. Managing your kryptonite. When you're on your success, when you're trying to get off the bench and get into the starting lineup of life, you've got to be focused. Things that distract you or take you away need to take a back seat. People aren't going to like it. They're not, but who cares? As my friend Miss Shea likes to say, do you, boo, just do you. And when you're doing you, know what your kryptonite is. Just one of those management tools, one of life skills. Because when we're able to know and identify what keeps us down or what takes us away, then we can kind of manage it. And usually when those things creep into our life or take over is when we lose focus on what and where we're trying to go and what we're trying to do. So my word to you today is find out what your kryptonite is and manage it. That's all I got right now. You can still pre-order my book at booksbymarkwiggins.com. Get it in. The book releases May 17th. I look forward to seeing you and signing those books and getting people off the bench into the starting lineup of life. Check me later. I'll holler. Oh, wait. And remember, if you can reach your goals with a stepladder, they're probably too low. I'm out.